Hi, my name is TsaeLing and I'm from Darjeeling, India. So I'm a teacher by profession and I'm here in Indonesia for an internship to teach English. And I chose Indonesia because it's a beautiful country. And I heard the teaching opportunities here are good as well. And today I'm going to make a dal, which is a very famous dish found in India. And it is kind of, how do I explain it for you? Maybe something like soup, but it's used with lentils. And we can have it with rice or with, like you call roti channe here in Indonesia. So we have roti or chapati or parathas in India. So come on, let's start the cooking journey. So let's start the cooking journey. Like I mentioned earlier, we'll be making dal today. For that, we need orange lentils. And so we need to wash it before cooking. So here we've washed it. And we need some tomatoes, onion, garlic, a bit of salt, and turmeric powder, which is very important for the color. And then we need clarified butter, which we call it in India as ghee. We can use the regular oil, but with this clarified butter, the taste is better. So let me start by chopping the onions. Since we're just making a little bowl of dal, half an onion will be enough. We need to chop it in small pieces. Once the onions are chopped, we move on to the garlic. Maybe two big pieces of garlic is enough. And chop them into small pieces again, just like we did the onions. And after we finish chopping them, it's nice that we press them, so that mash them, so that the flavor comes out. We still want the pieces there, which will give you better flavoring. Then we cut tomato. I think one tomato is enough. Cut them in maybe medium size. Yeah, so once we have that ready, we'll start the cooking. The pan is hot. We first put in the clarified butter. For this much, I think two spoons will be enough. Make sure the oil is spread out. We put in the onion. Make sure it's slightly golden brown. Yeah, once it's a bit golden brown, then we can add the garlic. Then we add in the turmeric powder. One small teaspoon is enough. Then we put in the tomato. We'll wait for less than a minute for the tomato to get a little soft. So now I'm adding the lentils. then salt. Right now I'm just adding 1 teaspoon. We can change that accordingly later once we get the taste of it. So I'm mixing it right now because making sure the salt and the turmeric powder has mixed in with the lentils. And we can let this fry for maybe a minute. Okay, so let me see how... Yeah, we should make sure it's not burnt. So just enough. And then I add in water. So we put a bowl of lentils, right? So for that, we need about 2.5 bowls of water. So I'm just going to check how much water should I put, because this can be up to you. If you want the dal to be very liquidy, like a soup, like, you need to add more water. And then I put on the lid and leave it to cook for about 20 minutes. Yeah. Okay, so it's been a little more than 25 minutes. So I think a dal is ready. Yeah. It smells nice, but I hope the taste is good as well. So we have the dal, and not to forget, we can use coriander leaves to garnish it. So just break the leaves into small pieces and... So there you go. Ye raha aapke liye dal. What is this? Okay, I've just got a challenge. Yeah, I've just got a challenge from the Cooking Journey team to make mee goreng. I have tried the mee goreng here in Indonesia, so let's see what I can do. So we'll start the journey here. Okay, so I've got a challenge from the Cooking Journey team to make mee goreng. So let's see what I can cook up. So here are the ingredients. We have spring onion, we have some chicken, which I've already cut into small slices, small pieces. And we have 2 eggs. And we have meatballs, some salt, pepper, onion, garlic, and olive oil. Then we have the sweet soy sauce and the salty soy sauce. So let's start. So I'll start by chopping the onions first. So in India also we have chicken chow mein, so it's the same way. So I'm going to use my knowledge from there, and then I hope I complete the challenge. So this time I'm chopping it into thin slices. The onions chopped, now we cut the garlic. I think two pieces are enough. So I'm gonna put that away, and now slice the garlic into maybe very small thin pieces. I'm going to cut it the same way I cut for dal. I'm not sure how the Indonesians cut it, but we'll see. I'm going to cut the meatballs. I'm cutting one meatball into four pieces. And then the chicken is already chopped, so let me beat the egg. And I'm gonna add some salt. Just a pinch of salt is enough. Little pepper as well. So just like we make an omelette, I'm going to do that and then, you know, fry, make the omelette and then mix it with the meat. Egg has been beaten. Oh, and yes, the spring onions, let me not forget. We just need a little bit, maybe. So I'm taking this much and I'm going to chop it into small pieces. So even this baso, we have it in India and yeah, we call it meatball soup. We have it in beef, in fish, as well as pork. Yeah, so we've got the ingredients all chopped up. Now let's see. Now we need to boil the mee and so that we can start the mee goreng. So now we've boiled the mee and it's ready. So let's start cooking. The pan is hot and we'll start by putting oil first. So we have olive oil here for the healthy eaters. I think this should do. We have to let the oil heat a little bit before putting in the onions. So yeah, while we're waiting for the oil to heat, let me tell you what was the first Indonesian dish I tried. The first thing was, I think that was nasi padang, like kind of like the buffet which you have set. So that was interesting. After that, yeah, after that was mee goreng. So, okay, I think the oil is ready. We'll put in the onions first. I'm breaking the chunks into small pieces. I'll put in the garlic. Okay, so now we'll put in the chicken because chicken takes a long time to cook. So I've already sliced the pieces. Then we'll add the egg which I had beaten earlier. Just put a little space in the wok so that the egg gets cooked. We can let that sit for a while and then once you see the omelette kind of thing forming, then I'm gonna stir it up. Yeah, okay, now the egg seems to be ready. So I'm stirring it. I'll put the meatballs now. I think even the nasi goreng is also the same way. We can just make all this mixture, the same mixture that we are doing for mee goreng. Just instead of mee, we have the rice. Now I'm gonna put the soy sauce. This is a salty one. And the sweet one. Just a little bit. Smells nice. add in the spring onions. Let that sit for maybe a minute and then we'll add on the mee and the salt. Well, this is according to my knowledge, I hope. I don't know if it's similar to the Indonesian style. We have to make sure we keep stirring, otherwise you'll see the egg and the meat getting burnt. So we don't want that. We have just lower the flame a little bit. Wow, the smell, I'm starving already. So now I'm gonna put in the mee. Just mix, make sure the mee is the flavor gets into the noodles. And then I'm gonna add a little pepper. Yeah, like half a teaspoon or yeah, a little more. I'm gonna add a little oil because I can see the noodles getting stuck a little bit. And then a little bit of soya. And salt, we need to be a little careful because we've used soy sauce, so that tends to have a lot of oil, salt in it. So we need to taste it first and then add the salt. I'm continuously stirring, making sure the oil and the flavor gets into the noodles. Once I see the noodles is slightly golden brown, then I think, then I'll know it's cooked. Making sure the egg and the chicken and the meatballs are all spread out. Yeah, I think we are done. It's ready. yeah, that's all. So we're gonna try. We'll see the cooking journey. Let's see what they say about my mee goreng. Okay, so the mee goreng looks cooked and ready to serve. I hope it is good enough for the Indonesian style. And then we'll use the coriander leaf again for garnishing. So here's mee goreng. I hope you like it, but this is my style. Yeah. So in today's cooking journey, I made dal from India and mee goreng, which was a challenge given to me. And so here we have it. I hope you like it, enjoy, and don't forget to catch the next episode of Cooking Journey and follow them on Twitter and Facebook at BINUSTV. Dada!